My father was being chased for an undercover drug operation. He was running from the cops. Shortly after my dad was incarcerated, my mom had my brother, and that was the first time my dad saw my brother, was behind a wire fence at visitation. And I didn't know that that wasn't normal. The first time I got caught breaking the law, I was in the fourth grade. Eighth grade year, going into ninth grade, everybody was like, hey, let's get drunk. And that was the first time I had drank. There was something inside of me that I wasn't okay with, and I used these things outside of me, like people and liquor, drugs. I used these things to try to make me feel better, and it never seemed to do the trick. I always needed a little bit more. I didn't know that I had an addiction. I didn't know that in my genes was someone who was bound to be incarcerated and drug addicted. I became a very serious IV meth user. I was smoking a lot of crack. I was doing a lot of robberies. I was a very shady individual. I was not to be trusted. When I look at these new clinics and the way that these satellite offices are embedded into the parole office, I think of like main control for reentry.
For those coming out not knowing where to start, not knowing what they need to do, having our probation staff educated on who to reach out to and kind of focus on what's most important and work on one thing at a time will help them succeed in the community. And that's where the Target Investment Program has come into play, that really closes the gap with communication and closing the gap for services. So we're not having to reach out to all these different providers, giving them a list of all these different names and numbers. It's just one place they need to go and everything can get handled here, which really helps improve the outcome for our clients.
The collaborative effort as the entire team helps the client with any services that they need. I received a phone call as I was leaving yesterday, and the person thanked me and for coming in and helping them. And I said, what made you come to us? He goes, I knew you'd help us.
A peer support specialist can kind of join with that person and say, hey, I'm going to walk this path with you. I'm going to walk this journey with you side by side. And so when you hit a bump or hit a snag, I can maybe share my experience of how I navigated that challenge. And it's really critical to have somebody that's kind of been there, done that, to say, hey, you can get through this. I've been through that too, and I know the way out.
You haven't lost your humanity because you've ended up in jail. And, you know, I validate them. I validate their pain, and I, you know, validate their experience, and I validate their humanity, which they, you know, a lot of times they'll come out just apologizing and thanking me, you know, and it's like, so one thank you is enough. You haven't lost your humanity, you have a need, and I'm here to provide you with that service to meet that need.
They could have given up on me rather than giving me that second chance, and because of the second chance, I'm doing so well today. Like, I'm so grateful for it. Like, seriously, I wanna cry.
All of that's happening under one roof, like with a whole team of people who have defragmented the whole system. And ultimately what we wanna be able to do is walk in there and have access to everything under one roof.